Today I'm officiating a wedding. It's my second one, and I'm very, very excited about it. So what they're doing is they're coming for a all-day private tour, and we're going to hug the cows and cuddle the turkeys and see all the animals, and we're going to have lunch together, and then I get to marry them. So this is going to be a really, really wonderful day.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, well, you don't know. This is like, you know, I don't know. It's what you do is amazing.
Sweet, sweet Lucy. So she's a miniature cow, and that's why she's so little. Hi, Lucy. Hi, Lucy. Hi, pretty girl. Aretha, are you coming to say hello to us as well? You guys can pet Aretha. She loves her back being scratched.
Her what?
Her back. Like her shoulders and her back. Hi, pretty girl.
Magic.
Feed as many of the donkeys as you can in the next 30 seconds. Here he comes. Time's up. Magic always comes and runs everybody off.
Magic. It's like, who are these two strangers?
I don't think he cares who you are as long as you're giving him carrots.
Hi. Oh my gosh, look at you.
Earl, she's getting married today to someone else, honey.
Hi. Oh, you're making me feel good. Look. Hi.
Earl would like you to reconsider and marry him instead.
Hi, boo-boo. Look at you, Earl.
I absolutely love that you're here at the Gentle Barn, and I think it's very poignant because the Gentle Barn is a home for second chances. Every single animal here has had a second chance and has made it here to find love again, to find peace and joy again, and to move on with their life in their happily ever after. And you are here today to find your second chance too, to find love again, to find joy again, and to move on in your happily ever after. So it's perfect that you're here. I believe that love and marriage is about finding a couple that is better as a couple than they are as individuals. You're naturally generous, and you're naturally generous. But together, you become this power couple that you're even more generous. You're doing more work for animals and rescue. You're putting more love out in the world. And you're more dynamic as a couple than you are as individuals. And I think that is the mark of a perfect marriage. So without further ado, Wes, do you take Hillary to be your lawfully wedded wife in sickness and in health, in prosperity and in poverty, in agreement and disagreement, in easy times and hard times? Do you wish to honor and cherish her the rest of your life?
I do.
And Hillary, do you take Wes to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love and cherish in sickness and in health, in prosperity and poverty, in agreement and disagreement, and at ease and difficulty?
I do.
Wes, will you place this on Hillary's finger, and will you recite, "With this ring I thee wed"?
With this ring I thee wed.
I be wed
with the authority of the state of California,
all the animals
here at the Gentle Barn, and Addison by your side, and hereby pronounce you husband and wife.
Yay.
And kiss the bride.
Love you.
Love you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So I'm driving down to the Natural Product Expo West. Very excited to get down there and see a lot of our corporate sponsors of the Gentle Barn Foundation. I'm gonna take you with me and we're gonna go check out a lot of the booths and the exhibit halls. Basically this expo is all about natural products. It's an incredible experience. It's totally overwhelming. There's so many people there, but my job is to be able to maneuver through, you know, all of the crowds and find my clients to get them excited about the Gentle 12, our program that highlights and spotlights our sponsors.
So time for registration. Found the second floor registration, which is a lot shorter than the first floor registration. So I'm gonna get in line here and get my badge.
So I'm all set up with my badge, ready to go in and take a look and see where everybody's at.
Lots and lots and lots of vendors. Gonna head over to see our friends at Pig Out Chips. Let's see how they're doing.
How are you? What's up, brother Dave? What's how are you, man? Good to see you.
Check it out.
We got the
Hello.
Big out booth.
Yeah, lots of
flavors. So this is all vegan, right?
Awesome. Yes. It looks really great.
How are you?
I didn't know you were. We're going to do at least one Gentle 12. If you'll have us in more than one, we'll do more. We really support your mission of saving pigs. Obviously, we have our own pig, our larger-than-life pig. Look at our pig out pig. Look at this guy. This gal, we don't even know what it is, but it's a giant pig that's always happy because you guys, Gentle Barn, are saving its kind, and you guys are doing an amazing job. We're happy and proud to be a sponsor and to have a pig out pig shelter at your location in Tennessee, and we couldn't be happier to support a mission-aligned organization like yours.
I said that he should smile. He says he always does.
Phenomenally vegan to
that.
Pig out.
Now that is commitment to brand.
This company, Vital Life, makes this Parmesan cheese. I'm sure their other products are amazing also, but this Parmesan cheese is a game changer. So you guys, Dr. Prager has been a supporter of the Gentle Barn for a long, long time. Very excited to see them at the show today. I'm gonna go over and see if we can work with them to be a part of our Gentle 12 program. They're absolutely wonderful products and very well made. Obviously natural product because they're here at the show.
Could not be more excited about being one of your brands and supporting your mission.
Awesome, thank you. So I'm over at Pacifica, one of our wonderful sponsors from this past year, and we're gonna be working with them to see if we can bring them in for our 2019 year. They have amazing, wonderful, cruelty-free, vegan product line.
Top products. That's what
I love the idea of doing this product with our pigs. They have an incredible sunscreen, and we can use the sunscreen on the pigs and do a promotion around that, and I think it'll be really exciting. That'll be really cool.
Over at Donut Farm, there he is!
Hey!
What is happening
How
with you?
How are you, Jay?
What are you doing here?
I'm
you
with Palm Done Right. I'm with Palm Done Right. We're talking about how palm is done right. Palm oil that our donuts are fried in.
Why does palm matter?
Jay, there's so much conflict palm in the world right now. It's a problem. The animal habitats, rainforests are being chopped down. It's an equivalent of fair trade for the palm oil industry. And Palm Done Right are the farmers, and they're growing.
That's Sun Chlorella, you guys. And look at this hot motorcycle that they are promoting their product with. And so the Sun Chlorella product line is something that we use every day at the Gentle Barn. Their wonderful, wonderful products are so rejuvenating and good for you. Especially if you're on a vegan diet, getting B12. The B12 complex is so important and really supports overall immunity and overall health, but also gives you the kind of nourishment that your body needs when you're recovering from a workout or needing energy. It's really a wonderful thing.
How to get all the
So I saw no evil last year. We met last year at this expo, and they just skyrocketed. This product is so wonderful, amazing taste. You guys got to try it. You're gonna love it. October, you get to try it all. Well, I'm hanging over here with our good friends. And Tommy is the chef for Field Roast.
Yeah.
Amazing book. His cookbook is right there. It's something that I've used quite regularly. I actually am probably one of the very few people who made a field roast.
Yeah. Oh, did you?
Yeah. I went through the whole process. It was really friggin' awesome. I made three.
You made three?
Three or two.
Sausages? Roasts?
I made a sausage and a roast.
Okay.
And something else.
Nice.
I mean, what was the other thing that I made? It was another roast.
Burger? No, not the burger.
No, do you have two roasts?
Stuffed roast.
I made the stuffed roast, and I made the regular field roast. So this is repurposed. Repurpose just changed their packaging. Looks amazing. They supply us with all of their products for us to use at the Gentle Barn in our events and in our office. And they all of these products are all made by plants, and they're all compostable. And they're just super, super amazing product line. They are a growing, emerging company. Great time to be this kind of company. And we really just love their support. So really, really, really exciting. I cannot believe we got through this thing. My legs are about to fall off. We sold our entire year. We sold our Gentle 12 product line to support these amazing natural product companies in getting their product out to our patrons.
What an incredible opportunity to be out at a place where it's such high vibration, good consciousness, and great products supporting and changing this planet.
This is the first time in several years that I've missed the Natural Product Expo. I had to drive Cheyenne to dance, and I wanted to spend some time one-on-one with the kids.
How about your food, Cheyenne? How is it? Looks amazing.
The magical thing about the Natural Product Expo is you leave there with such an immense sense of hope for the planet and hope for everyone. There's thousands of vendors all producing products that are kind to the environment, kind to animals, and kind to our bodies. And there are all these innovators that are just thinking outside the box, not going with the norm, not destroying the planet, not making bodies ill, not torturing animals, but being part of the solution and part of the future of this planet. And it is so invigorating, and all the food tastes amazing, all the body products smell, it's amazing. It's just a wonderful feel-good experience where we're saving the planet. We're part of the future. We're part of the solution. It's gonna be okay.
Oh, that looks amazing. Yeah. So good. So most people would consider going to the park with four dogs a handful, but we're going to the park with four dogs and a chicken, of course. Peggy gets to come to the park too. She loves to look around and have a change of scenery and socialize with everybody as we pass by. And she always gets a lot of attention.
Today we're giving a tour to Tammy Fry of the Fry Family Food Company from South Africa, actually, and they make amazing vegan products. And we're going to show them all our animals and talk about the sanctuary today.
We've got a river running through the Gentle Barn. We've had so much rain. Usually this river is dry because there's not much rain in California, but now it's been raining for several days now, so everything's green. And there's a river running under our bridge.
Oh, listen to
this. Excuse me, sorry. Look how wonderful that is.
When we first moved in here, the water, we were warned about the water. The water came to just 1 inch below the bridge in our first year. So this is a lot of water, but it's not the kind of water that we've seen.
But look, honey, we've got riverfront property. Hi, are you having a nice afternoon? So beautiful. Forgiveness is over 3,000 pounds and over 7 feet tall, and he is the most gentle man you will ever meet. Hi! Hi, Ferdinand! Hi, sweetheart! May I pet you and say hello? Hi! You're a good boy, you know that?
can't ever say the B word when you're out in the barnyard. Because if you say the B word, then everybody starts running.
And by B word, we're talking about banana.
Don't
say it. I don't want people to think we're talking about another word. Hi, King. Do you want a treat?
So just break it into little 1-inch pieces and flat it.
He doesn't like being pet. He just wants to be fed.
He loves taking selfies, though. That's his thing.
Sorry, King. Did you eat the whole banana? Was that so good?
Look at his teeth. He's even got a little bit left.
His favorite. Bananas are his favorite.
With us again. Hi, Earl. Oh, Earl, I thought you were in a nice mood earlier.
Okay, okay. I'm just going to give you a scratch here. Okay? It's very cool.
There you go. Here, Amelia.
Only 1 feet
up. Here, darling. Stanley! Here. There you go. Amelia, you already had one. Hannah, there you go. Guys, here, Gus. Hannah, you don't want one? Okay, everybody. That was fun giving you treats. We love you. That is one happy pig. You're very handsome. You're very handsome out there.
Is he doing the peacock thing?
Yeah, he's showing off for us. Romeo, come show us how handsome you are. If you rub his belly kind of like faster and harder, and a little bit lower, he'll start grunting thank yous. But you have to do it harder.
Okay.
And then like between his front legs. There he goes. I just dropped Cheyenne off at dance. Jay and I kind of joke like we run the gentle barn during the day and by night we're dance parents. It's been raining all day and the clouds are so beautiful. It's nice to have some rain in California for a change. These are my co-pilots. The dogs always come with me to bring Cheyenne to dance. It's so fun riding with them. You know, I was always obsessed with animals and wanted to bring them home and save them, and my parents always got rid of them and didn't really support who I was. As a matter of fact, my parents kept saying, you know, stop your nonsense, don't be ridiculous. So, the fact that I can kind of take that and turn it around to learn how to take care of Cheyenne and how to support who she truly is, it kind of like makes what I went through worth it, because in going through what I went through, I learned how to be a better parent to Cheyenne and how to take care of her and support her dreams and help her shine. So, you know, we're busy and we have so much responsibility, but getting in the car, holding her hand and driving her to dance every day is one of my favorite things. Good to be home. That was fun. Home sweet home. I am very lucky to be married to Jay. He's an amazing chef, and when he gets in the kitchen, oh my god, it's just deliciousness that's coming out. But, you know, sometimes he's not here, he's working, he's busy, and sometimes he doesn't feel like cooking, so I still have to learn to fend for myself sometimes. So tonight, I'm making dinner. Because Jay and I are on the Engine 2 diet, I'm not going to cook with oil. I'm actually frying with water, so I just put a little hot water in there. and I'm gonna saute my onions right in the water. I'm gonna turn the heat just a little lower, and I'm gonna let those onions get nice, soft, and translucent right in the water. Then I chopped up some tofu. I love tofu. And I chopped up some broccoli. And I'm gonna put some sweet potatoes in the oven. All I'm gonna do is use a fork to make some holes around the sweet potato, and I'm gonna put it right on the oven rack itself. I set it to about 375, and I'm gonna leave it in there for an hour. And I've set some forbidden rice to boil on the pot. It's the easiest thing in the world. 1 3/4 cup water, 1 cup rice, set to boil, and then simmer for 30 minutes, and it's delicious. These onions are simmering so nicely in the water. Now I'm gonna add my spices. So Jay taught me a lot about spices. I was very timid before, kind of being careful and not really sure what spices to use. But he taught me what spices to like, but also to not be timid about it. So in my stir fry, I'm gonna use some garlic, paprika, a little bit of pepper, cumin, I'm in love with celery salt. I don't know why, but I love it. So I'm gonna use a lot of celery salt. And then I'm gonna use some oregano. And I don't really know like what spices are good, and basically what I do is I just go through the spice cabinet and I smell them, and if it smells really savory and good and I'm called to it, then I use it. So, and then now I can put the broccoli and the tofu right in there, and it'll mix with the onions and the spices and the water, and it'll get really yummy. I get to have a conversation with Peggy. Hi Peggy.
Hi.
So sweet. She just sits in her little chair and she drinks her San Chlorella water and she eats her food, and she has such a beautiful voice, and she's always talking to me while I cook. I love having her in the kitchen with me. What else, Peggy? What else? You have such a beautiful voice. You have such a beautiful voice. It's time to make another crock pot for the dog's vegan food, and I want to do it. So first I start with beans and lentils, and kind. It can be red kidney beans, black beans, northern beans, any kind of lentils. So in my house right now, I've got red, black, and great northern beans, and I've got green lentils. So that's what I'm going to start with. Sweet potatoes, and then I found some cabbage in the fridge, so I added cabbage. The thing about this recipe is you want quinoa, beans, and lentils because that's where the protein comes from. But then you can add any kind of vegetable you want. You can. I like to use sweet potato because I think it's really nutrient rich. And then add something green. You know, look in your fridge, see what you got. Add 2 or 3 chopped vegetables, and away you go. I'm gonna switch it up this time, and instead of quinoa, I'm gonna do rice, because brown rice, lentils, and beans make a perfect protein. And now you just fill it with hot water till it covers the veggies. Cover, set, some crock pots have timers and some don't. If it has a timer, I would set it on low for 8 hours. If it does not have a timer, I set mine on high for a couple hours and then I set it back on low for overnight. And then in the morning, you have a delicious meal not only for your dogs, but for yourself. And the next morning, it's all done. And it's warm, full of color and nutrients, and the dogs love it.
Time for a little dance dad action, picking up Cheyenne at dance class over here at Light Dance Complex. And see if we catch the tail end of some of her dance.
Appreciation day for you. All those Gentle Barn fans out there, we love the whiners, and as you can see, we have a plethora of amazingness. I'm so blessed. Hey.
You got some more followers now.
Two turns. Let's get Cheyenne over at dance class.
Guys, thanks for coming on these adventures with us. Please like, subscribe, and share.